The Silla is a site operated by the European Southern Observatory, ESO, in the South American country of Chile, that has housed telescopes since the late 1960s. Situated at the southern edge of the Atacama Desert, it is incredibly dry, which means a low number of cloudy nights per year, very different to European skies. Its southern hemisphere position gives great views of the centre of our own galaxy, the Milky Way, as well as that of the wider universe, having some of the darkest skies in the world. Its altitude of around 2,500 metres also means that the effect of the atmosphere, which makes stars twinkle, is greatly reduced. Its position at the eastern edge of the Pacific Ocean means that the air flowing over it is smooth, having avoided becoming turbulent after encountering mountainous obstacles, which again reduces twinkling, an effect called seeing by astronomers, which we want to minimise. It's a long journey, taking more than 24 hours, but that's a small price to pay for observing at one of the best sites in the world.
The University of Southampton Supernova Group is part of a worldwide collaboration of 27 research institutes called PESSTO, the Public ESO Spectroscopic Survey of Transit Objects. Our science scope is to explore the diversity of the optical transit universe. We are a follow-up scientific survey, meaning that our primary job is to closely follow transit events. Additionally, we classify unknown objects with the hope that these are new and exciting discoveries. PESTO started observing in 2011 on the 3.5-meter new technology telescope mounted at the Silla Observatory in Chile. It runs 9 months per year, from August to April, with subruns of 9 to 10 days per month. Up until now, PESTO has classified around 800 transits, follows almost 175 of them, and authored 30 scientific papers.
We observe supernovae in different ways depending on what we want to learn. Broadly, we use two different techniques and two different instruments on the new technology telescope at ESO La Silla to do this. When we want to measure the brightness of an object, we do photometry. This essentially uses the telescope as a giant digital camera to take a picture. When we want to classify an object and find out what kind of supernova it is, we use spectroscopy, splitting the light up like a prism and with a narrow slit measuring the intensity at different wavelengths. The intensity of the light, or lack thereof, gives us clues as to which layer of the supernova ejecta is emitting the light and what it's composed of. As well as allowing us to type the supernova, this information is also scientifically useful, so we often return to objects many times in a run that we've already classified to see what has changed. With each of these two techniques, we can use either EFOSC-2, the visible light instrument on the NTT, or SOFI in the near-infrared.
Thank you. Supernovae are cosmic explosions signifying the death of some stars. Some of these stars are many times the mass and size of our Sun and explode due to the rebound of the stellar atmosphere following a violent implosion of the core. We call these core collapse supernovae. Others are much smaller, parasitic white dwarfs which consume neighbouring stars until they cannot hold themselves up against gravity, undergoing a thermonuclear runaway explosion. These are type 1a supernovae. We study these objects for a number of reasons. The light they emit can tell us a great deal about the state of the star before it exploded, its mass, age and composition. We can use this information to test our understanding of stellar evolution, how stars change as they age. Also important is the material blown out by the supernova. The high energies involved turn lighter elements into heavier ones, a process called nuclear synthesis. We can look at the elements present in our local universe, and through studying supernovae, understand how and why they are present, and in what amounts. Finally, type 1a supernovae are useful cosmologically for measuring the universe around us. They are what is known as a standardizable candle, meaning that with some corrections for duration and color, they are all the same brightness. Thus, if we see one and measure its brightness, we know how far away it is. This technique was used to determine that the universe's expansion is accelerating, work that in 2011 was awarded the Nobel Prize. With PESTO observations, we hope to better understand the corrections due to colour and duration, improving their efficiency, and also to shed light on the progenitor system of the supernova before it exploded, which still remains unknown today.
Just be careful of the camera.